제34회 백화점보다 훨씬 싸요.
안녕하세요. Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Speak Korean, your guide to the wonderful language of Korea and its people. Next to me is our wonderful, wonderful co-host, Stephen.
You've been using this adjective a lot lately. Wonderful. Yes, thank you very much, Lisa.
I'm just enjoying all those coffees you bring me before the show.
You're very kind with your introductions. It's wonderful to be here with you folks again. Today, we're going to talk about an area of Korea, one of my favorites. Last time we talked about buying something and bringing it back. This time, we're going to talk about a great place to go buy something. And who are we going to talk about it with? Of course, Jason and Miriam.
안녕하세요, 리사 씨. 안녕하세요, 스티븐 씨. 안녕하세요, 저는 미리엄입니다. And speaking of shopping, you know what Jason bought me yesterday?
What's that?
Really?
His hairpin! Right here!
These two are starting to get real friendly, aren't they?
Yeah. Wait, no.
Did you see her lean over there with the...
No.
Jason bought me?
He was supposed to buy me coffee. Mm-hmm. But he didn't want to use too much money, so he preferred to buy me this hairpin.
No, actually, that hairpin looks pretty expensive. What do you mean?
Well, we bought it in Dongdaemun.
Oh, okay, that explains it.
Yeah.
Well, you can get nice stuff in Dongdaemun for cheaper prices. It's not where you get cheap stuff. It's just really nice items for a much cheaper cost. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, it says on my script here today that I'm supposed to say... If you want to learn Korean, don't just bring your notepad and pen, but you must go out and experience with the Korean people and its culture. But I don't like that. Because
well,
I
want to
say, don't just bring your pen and notepad, come with us and learn here at Let's Speak Korean. Isn't that a better line?
I hate it when she gets away from the script.
Okay, sorry.
I hate it when you... Yeah, well, it's a good line. Learning with Let's Speak Korean is good, too. But you need the practical experience, too,
okay,
right? You got to meet those Koreans.
We forgot about Jason.
Oh, yeah, okay. Hi, Jason.
After all I do for you people, how could you forget about me?
I didn't get any hairpin. I have no hairpin.
That's it. No more hairpins or coffee for you folks.
All right.
안녕하세요. 저는 Jason입니다.
Let's teach Korean, shall we? Everybody, let's take a look at what we're going to learn today. Let's do it!
동대문 시장에 가봤어요?
아니요.
한번 가보세요. 백화점보다 훨씬 싸요.
Earlier, we heard Miriam say that she got her hairpin from 동대문 market, okay? Here, we hear 동대문 시장, which is 동대문 market. 가봤어요? 가 is the verb for go. Have you been to Dongdaemun Market? And apparently Jason and Miriam have.
Yes.
예, 어제 가봤어요.
Oh, you went yesterday. Have you been to Dongdaemun Market?
Yes, many times. I love Dongdaemun Market. One reason is it's mainly a night market. So it's a lot of fun to go shopping at 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock at night.
Until morning.
But yes, but let's teach some Korean here. We need to get into Korean at some point, don't we? When you've tried something, when you're talking about whether you have tried something, you're going to use the verb plus 아 or 어, 보다, okay? That's, 보다 is kind of to have tried something, okay? 가 봤어요 is have been to somewhere, right? Because 가 is to go. So when you want to say, have you gone somewhere? You say 가 봤어요. 아, it seems like it should be 가 봤어요, doesn't it? It should be, but when you put two ahs up next to each other, one, of course, disappears because you can't pronounce ah together without a consonant in between. So you say 가 봤어요. Then, let's say, our trusty verb with the 받침, with the final consonant, 먹다. If you have 먹다, what are you going to say? You're going to have to say 먹다.
먹어봤어요,
right? You have to stick in that other consonant in between, so it comes 먹어봤어요.
And most likely, if you're living in Korea, you haven't hit everywhere yet, so you're going to say 아니요, no, I haven't. So the other person will respond by saying, hey, try it out once, or go over there and visit it once, by saying 한번, which is once, 가보세요, once again the same verb, and try it out. 한번 가보세요. Go there once.
한번 가보세요.
한번 가보세요.
And the reason would be because, well, 동대문 and 남대문, which are the two big markets here
wholesale
in Korea,
right, yeah.
are very cheap. You can get really nice stuff for cheap prices, as we mentioned earlier. And so it's much cheaper than the 백화점, which is the department store. So we want to say 백화점보다, okay, we're comparing here, 훨씬 싸요. 싸 means very cheap, and 훨씬 means very much so. So 백화점보다 훨씬 싸요.
백화점보다 훨씬 싸요.
백화점보다 훨씬 싸요.
Very energetic usage of the verb, of the adjective 훨씬.
Because they know it's much cheaper.
Yes. 훨씬 is always used for comparisons, okay? So 훨씬 커요. Much bigger. 훨씬 커요. Or much smaller. 훨씬 작아요. Right? 훨씬 작아요. Or much more delicious. 훨씬 맛있어요.
Right. And some similar words, other than 훨씬, you can use 아주. 아주 싸요, 아주 커요, or you can say 참 싸요. Oh, 참 싸요. Do you want to try it out once?
참 싸요.
아, 참 싸요.
And 아주 커요.
동대문 시장은 아주 커요.
Good.
동대문 시장은 아주 커요.
Mm-hmm. 보다 is kind of, I compare it to in English, than, okay? Notice it is 백화점보다 훨씬 싸요. Much cheaper than a department store, right?
Right.
Much cheaper than a department store is what is being said there. So the 보다 is kind of like than.
And having said that, why don't you guys make some sentences comparing two things for us?
You try first.
Since Marion can't think of one at the
start.
영어보다 한국말이 더 쉬워요.
훨씬 더 쉬워요.
Is that true?
Not really true, but anyway.
Okay, Miriam?
리사 씨는 스티븐 씨보다 훨씬 날씬해요.
Yes, thank you very much.
The coffee.
Okay, the coffee. You love coffee on this set. Okay, she just said, I am so much more thinner than Steven. No, that's not true. You know I got my... You know, deposits of fat accumulated here and there. Anyways, let's go to our wrap it up corner while we discuss Steven's stomach. And we'll be back in a minute.
Wrap it up
with Lisa
and Steven.
빈대떡 먹어봤어요?
아니요, 안 먹어봤어요.
한번 먹어보세요. 피자보다 훨씬 맛있어요.
빈대떡 is actually a really delicious thing, and I think we've been through this before. Koreans like to eat it on a rainy day.
That's right. Well, let's wrap up by trying out each of our sentences one more time. Today we practice the comparative, comparing one thing to another, and asking if you have gone or seen or done something. So, Miriam, Jason, go for it.
Okay. 빈대떡은 피자보다 훨씬 맛있어요.
Ooh.
I think 떡볶이는 빈대떡보다 훨씬 맛있어요.
No, that's not true.
Yes, it is. You're a 떡볶이 fan, huh? It's tough to kind of figure these all out. 떡볶이? Huh? 무엇보다? The thing that is less comes next to 보다. So, 떡볶이가 빈대떡보다 훨씬 맛있다고요?
All right, and that about wraps it up for today's show. It gets a little confusing, I think, even in the English language when someone's learning how to compare one thing to the other because you want to know what comes before the thing you're comparing with. But But practice makes perfect, of course. You know, you'll be as good as Steven very soon. All right, thank you for joining us. Please come back next time. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.